You are going to see now list of tables, all of them to do with this year, 5779, and very, very interesting of them, as you see yourself, clear signs that this Passover, this Pesach can be a time of Messiah. But as always we see, everything depends on repentance. Jews will keep the Torah, the Sabbath. So what we see here is a verse, Kiet lecha na kiva moed, in English, why it's famous, it is Psalm 102:14. You will, God says, you will arise and have compassion on Zion, for it is time to show favor to her. The appointed time has come. So what is the appointed time? So in Hebrew, et lecha nena, this is the idea. And let us see the numerical value of it. So the value of the verse, part of the verse, time to favor them, the appointed time, kibamo, it came. Now it comes in numerical value 766, which is definitely before. Apparently we lost this time, but as you saw, if you really followed my YouTube properly, there is a numerical value which takes also the letters, the number of letters, in consideration. This is part of Gematria. I wrote a whole book about all the keys of Gematria, about 200 pages. One can get them if you put Gleason.com, but Gematria is not simple, not one way, you know, full Gematria. You might have the kollel, with the letters, and everything has a reason. So the letters in Et Lecha Na Kiva Moed, this verse, are 15. So together it comes to 781, which is the numerical value of in 5779. The Tavshin Ayintet in 5779. This is the numerical value coming 781. So interesting, clearly indicating is important to this year. Now the tables that are going to see now, different ones, all of them really round this number. So let us see now, stage by stage. Now the first thing really is a table that in Hebrew you saw it, but not it in English, but now you see it properly again. And as you will see, what is behind, very interesting. So really, let us start first with a table I did in Hebrew, not in English, and now you see it in English. Very, very interesting. So what you see in this table, we are looking for the year 5779, Passover, Pesach, amazingly, once in the Torah, you had it, Tavshin Ayintet, Pesach, in one skip, amazing, once in the Torah. So, clearly shows the connection between Pesach, Passover, and this year, what we hope will be, what they believe the Messiah, which comes here, Messiah in red, and the son of Jesse, in blue. In fact, you have again, son of Jesse, interesting, twice. So, clearly, indicates that this Passover of 5779 can be a year of Messiah. But as always, we see clearly, in significant way, the repentance, the condition, with this. Maimonides says, the Rambam says, any Israel regalim, Israel will not be redeemed unless they will repent. But God and the Torah promise they will do repentance. Who knows why, but they will do. And the appearance of the Tshuvah, the repentance, is the minimum in the whole Torah, exactly with the story which tells us that Pharaoh came near and Israel lifted out their eyes, so the Egyptian running after them, the sea definitely before, so very, very difficult situation. So they did repentance, they cried to God, this is written, and repentance comes here. Very interesting, minimum in the Torah, exactly in the right time, like here also Israel are really, unfortunately, you have enemies from all over. want to wipe them out, like there. Now you have Elijah and Israel, because they have a connection, Elijah will come with the Messiah, no doubt. And then, what we have here also interesting is the verses. Now, there's no place for the verses, so we did it here. So, now this is a verse, which you see here, in black, which says, Ki tavo la milchama, tavo milchama ba'arzachem al asar, tzorei atchem, ra'atem b'chotzatzot, and so on. So what is the verse about? So as you see here, saying the following, and if you go to war in your land against the enemies that oppress you, right? Now, this is a verse which clearly speak about the war of Gog and Magog. This is what the rabbi says in the Merkel Valley of Tabor, Milchama is Gog and Magog in Balaturim. And this is refers to this kind of war. Now, what is interesting, that the few great rabbis said, the commentary says that the idea of the war, which is going to take place in the future, is exactly the same kind of war that was in Hanukkah. And they say, interesting, the Hebrew word Hanukkah come from the word chinuch, education. So it educates, teaches us how to fight with Gog and Magog in future. And in fact, the great teacher is Matityahu, the Zazmaniah. You have Matityahu, Zazmaniah. Exactly at that time, you know, when the Greeks fought against Jews, wanted to defile, to contaminate all what they do, the daughters of Israel, the oil, everything to cause it impurities, yeah? And many Jews, unfortunately, went astray, left the Torah, and they joined the Greeks. Exactly the same thing like today. You have physical war, definitely, all the terrorists, the Arabs, Iran, Hezbollah, all of them, Jihad, Hamas, PLO. So, physically, but also spiritualists. You can see in Israel that, like Lapid and Meretz, those leftists, really don't want to keep Shabbat. They want to allow transport on Shabbat and allow the segregation of the Shabbat. Exactly like at that time, the Greeks fought against the Shabbat, did not allow Jews to keep Shabbat. So this is the same thing. This is why you have this verse here, which is very interesting to do. Now, what is the most interesting in this table, that when I was looking for the meeting of Passover 5779, so it means Tavshin 9, Tavshin with repentance and with Messiah and so on. Passover is the time for Messiah. I saw that exactly in this place, you can see in black, the verse is the following, what you see here in red, the feast of unleavened bread that thou keep 7 days or should. Eat unleavened bread, as I commanded, at the time appointed in the month Aviv, the spring. Amazingly, exactly, when I was looking for Passover, 5 7 9, so it was exactly the verse in the Torah, which speaks about Passover. It says here, that Chag HaMatzot is the festival of Matzot, Tishmor, you should keep it 7 days, and you should eat only matzot, like God commanded you. So it's amazing, even the location of the place, peace with this. So, really, let us hope that the Jews will do the tshuva, repentance, and on this Passover we will have already the Messiah. Then, let us see another interesting table, also in which we have the 7, 5, 7, 7, 9. And this is really what we did before about the election. Let us repeat it, but amazing, the election in Israel will be, as we see just now, was exactly the time which is, as we know, the 4th of Nisan, few days before Pesach, Passover, and there came out also the idea of repentance. Amazing. Tshuva came there, as you see just now, come here clearly in this table. So you see here the elections on the fourth of the first month, which is Nisan, election, and then 5779. And also Messiah, the time of Messiah, is the other thing. And the condition, repentance, then we have also the son of Jesse, keeping of the Shabbos, amazing, all of this coming here. 5778 is also here because this is the counting of the years from the creation of man, which was really next year. It was after the year of the creation of the world. 6 days afterwards came this date, and Messiah is the reincarnation of Adam, Adam, David, Messiah. So this way it comes also here, but you have repentance, you have son of Jesse, and you have keeping the Torah differently. And 5779, but amazingly, in such a small area, you can see it, even if you don't Hebrew, you can see that the letter is one letter of Dalet, the numbers, and one chapter, Kafre 28, few verses in this chapter. So amazing to have such a small table in so many related verses, all of them related, elections, yeah, Bachodesh HaRishon Barba, in the first month, which is Nisan. We know we count from the Nisan spring, the beginning of the year, and from Jewish. But it's amazing that we have exactly the same place, but we see always the Messiah in 577 supposed to come, but the condition, amazing in the center, Teshuvah, but keeping the Shabbat, purity of life, definitely. Amazing what we see in this table also about the importance 5779. Now let us see another one, which also we have 5779 here. And this really has a lot of words, because most of the things in this table really is a really made interesting table in which you see really once in the Torah came the sentence. The sentence came en pitaron, no solution to the situation in Israel. It means the Arabs, the terrorists, the Islam, the Arab, Hamas will carry on, all the Amalekites will carry on doing a lot of troubles to Jews, to Israel through terror. Yeah, and the evenly angel of come here of the Amalekite comes, Assam, and pitaron, no solution to the situation in Israel. Iran coming here is unbelievable, but here comes Messiah. This is the most interesting, that from this situation, yeah, that unfortunately Israel will be, they will come to do repentance, to repent, to do tshuva, and then keeping the Torah. Torah is like fire. Like the Torah is written that with the Torah, Torah is like fire to burn all the enemies of Israel, of Jews. So as I said, very, very interesting. And here also you have that all this will develop in 5779 with the Ishmaelites, by the way. Ishmael comes, very small skip. So it means altogether another clear table, very, very significant. So many words come together related. And clearly telling what the Rambam says. Clearly said it Rabbi Eliezer, a gadol, more than 2,000 years old, that the Ishmael is called Ishmael in future, why future? Because he will do so many troubles to Jews, through terror, through all kinds of things. And this is the Islam, really, this is the Islam, very small, the smallest in the Torah, because the Islam is the root of the troubles to Jews, the Arabs, because they believe in the Islam as they understand it, and according to this, especially Iran said, you have to wipe out the Jews. So, amazingly, you can see that this kind of troubles, you know, with Amalekite, with the Islam, with the Arabs, with Hamas, with Fatah, the problem of the terror, see, all of this, really, even will not be a solution to this. Why not? Because the purpose of these Arabs is to bring Jews to keep Torah, Shabbos, and all these things. So all the time, Jews will not keep it. You will not have peace and quiet. Then, let us see another table. Also have 5779 here. You have 5779 here, Messiah. Israel also through the Torah. And through the Torah, son of David come here, Elijah comes here. But again, in the center, repentance. Yeah, exactly like the repentance. You can show here. In blue, repentance in 5779 will bring us the Messiah, Israel, but keeping the Torah. And Elijah will come, the son of Jesse, the Messiah. And definitely this is the ideal, and this was supposed to be. I, again, by repentance. And again, 5779, as we saw, even this verse. Then, let us see more about this. And here also you have something very interesting. And this is what really we start in the beginning of the year. But clearly came out also that this year, 5779, can be very important and good year. His happiness by only understanding and wisdom, blessing, faith, this is most important, faith in God. And it could be a good year, son of Jesse, but, as we said, only keeping the Torah. So, here the Torah come parallel, definitely. So, important and interesting table also shows that this year could be a very good one because many indications that it's a year of Messiah. Here what we have is also very, very interesting, and let us see more about it here. So this is really what tell us about also very small skip of 5779. So in fact, this we miss it, but we miss Hanukkah, but because of repentance, yeah? And didn't repent. If you repent, we have already Zen, but now we have other chances. But it's so interesting, really, that you have the Torah here also, repentance, very small, it's the smallest skip in the Torah, 5779. So, as we said, unfortunately, repentance was necessary and was not so. We have to wait to another opportunity, and the opportunity is this weeks after, up till Passover. Now, this is what we saw already, and this also we saw, all 5-9. This is also son of David, Elijah, will come, 5-7-7-9. And this is most interesting, as we said, that you have Passover, 5-7-7-1 in the Torah. We is exactly the location of the Torah about Pesach. And everything comes here. So very, very, very interesting. Very significant tables, as we saw, about the time that we are now, and hoping really that Jews will do tshuva, will repent, and will merit to have really what is written there, yeah, that God says, you will arise and have compassion on Zion, for it is time to show favor to her. The appointed time has come, and amazing, and a miracle value comes exactly to this year. But again, the condition, the very important condition is tshuva, repentance, which appears on each table that we have here, 5779. So, let us hope the Jews will do the tshuva, and then will merit to have proper redemption in this time. By the way, this in this table, you have all the different names for Messiah. I mean, there's one Messiah, but all the different things that you will have to do, you have your Shiloh, you have your the Inon, another name, you have Hananiah, right? But all of them Messiah, because we know there are different names of the Messiah, but each man represents another aspect of what he will do. Shiloh, the nation will bring presence to him. Hananiah with mercy, he will bring mercy on Israel. Inon, kingdom. And all of this will bring a change, you know, to Israel and to the whole world. By the way, a very interesting sentence here. The power of repentance, because repentance, this is a power with which, really, we live Messiah, son of Jesse. And this will change people, yeah? So let's assume that this is what will be. So, interesting list of tables, as we said. All of them have 5779 with Messiah, son of Jesse. But, as we said, repentance. And the most interesting is really this one, which we have. The minimal is the Torah of Passover, 5779, together with the minimal of repentance, which itself very, very highly significant. Dr. Rotenberg says his program that we are using says that the most important is the tables are minimals. So when you have minimal, this will make it very interesting. But definitely all this idea of location, the location of the place, is also dealing with Pesach. So the skip about Pesach comes in the location of Pesach or Passover. So all those tables are very significant and teaching us that this Pesach, this Passover, can be a time of Messiah, son of Jesse. So let us hope that really will, during this time, during this month that we have from now to Passover, we have now coming the month of Shvat, then the month of Adar, Purim, also important, very important festivals. And then we have 2 weeks for Passover, so about 2.5 months, yeah. So, important tables, significant tables, which hope will have some impact on people, but it looks that somehow the Satan is too strong, doesn't allow people to really change. Yeah, it's difficult to change, not to keep Shabbos, to do things which are not the right things to do, especially men and women. And so, no. So maybe this is what will bring, as the Maimonides, a situation that Israel will have to repent. Like 6 Devor, six Devor, half of Tel Aviv was ready for a cemetery. Nobody knew that such great miracles would take place. And in fact, the first yeshivas of Baalei Teshuvah started on the year 1967, or Sameach, Esh HaTorah. Those yeshivas started then, because many became religious when they saw that only miracles saved them. So important tables and important teaching and message, and hoping that really, sof-sof, as we see in Hebrew, sof-sof, the end will be that really people will keep the Shabbos, keep the laws of the Torah. The Gentiles have to keep the 7 laws of Noah, also important. And only this will bring peace and tranquility to the whole world.